So you want to get heaps more students for your music teaching business, but you got $0 to spend on marketing? That's what we're going to talk about today. I'm going to give you about 7, 8, 9 ideas that you can do for $0 to get new students fast. Okay, so let's get straight into it. And if you like content like this to help you build a more successful music teaching business or even your own music school, click subscribe. This is where we share all our best stuff on how we built my music school to 2,000 students and how we built the best music school coaching program in the world with hundreds and hundreds of people across 25 countries building successful schools that have even gone way bigger than mine. Someone's even built one to 4,000 students, twice as big as mine. So join us for the journey. But today we're talking all about how do you get students quickly with $0 to spend. So let's get into it. Number one, first thing I want to give you, before I give you any new strategies, first thing I want to give you is one that's often neglected, and it's just do more of what's already working. You need to actually ask all your parents, students, hey, how did you find out about us? How did you become a student here? Did someone tell you? Did you see, I don't know, a logo on a building, a logo on my car? Did you hear about us at the local school? Like whatever it was, how'd you hear about us? Because if you can find out and do a bit of a pie chart, how did everyone hear about us? If you have a clear winner, like, oh, we saw your Instagram page. It's like, great, let's figure out how we can double down on Instagram and do more of that. If it was like, hey, you came along to our school and did a little talk in an assembly or a performance. Great, how can we double down on that? And even things like word of mouth, like, oh, yeah, we all came here because you know, other students told us that it was great. You might think, oh, okay, well, I can't really double down on that. Yes, you can. You can inspire people to do better word of mouth. You can run competitions. You can have really cool prizes for the number of people sign up. So you can give out special vouchers and golden tickets for lessons given by other students. So whatever you're doing that's been working, figure out how you can double down on that. So that's the first thing. Second thing, let's get into some tactical things. And some will be ones that you may know and have already done. Others might be new to you. So let's just power on. Number two, posting in local community Facebook groups. The key here is find all the best groups, take lots of great photos of you in lessons, you know, ask if it's okay with students, find real life action shots of you, you know, teaching your instrument, students smiling, having a great time, and start posting a schedule and just post in this group this day, the next group the next day, the next group the next day. Be consistent, share different posts of students winning and in their lessons having fun. You might share a post like, here's a little clip of young Stevie. Stevie, can you believe it? He didn't even know how to hold the drumsticks 6 weeks ago. Here he is playing along to his favorite song without stopping. You know, that's a cool student win video, right? You might have just a post where it's like you smiling at your instrument and you literally just go, looking for awesome piano lessons? My name's Johnny, I'm a local piano teacher, and if you've ever wanted to play some of your favorite songs or play in a band or just love playing piano to yourself at home after a long hard day, I'd love to teach you how to be a great pianist. I have some spots available, this is how my lessons work. If you would like some information, comment down below, info, and I'll get back to you. Then you're going to reply to those comments and say, hey, thanks, Susan, I've sent you a message with the info. And then you reply in a private message to that person, whether this is Facebook or it's Instagram, and you just you send them a private message, and you don't want to give them all the info straight away because it can be like triggered as a spam message. What you'd do is you'd say, hey, Susan, just checking that you've got my message. Once you give me the okay, I'll send you all the info about lessons. Okay, and then you wait for her to reply. Yes, that'll be great, send it now. And then you send the info. Now you're in a conversation, and of course text is even better than email because people always have their phone on them and they're checking it more than they check their email. So that is how I would think about starting the second idea, posting in community groups and just being consistent, doing it consistently with lots of variations in the types of things you're posting, commenting and trying to reply to every comment so it keeps those posts engaged, and just making sure that you don't over spam groups. So there's the second free thing. Third thing, win back campaigns. How often have you reached out to all your ex-students and go, hey, how you doing? You know, are you still interested in music lessons? Would you like to come back? And, you know, just having a conversation. The thing that's going to be the best that most people, you just won't even do because you might be scared or nervous to do it. but it'll outperform every other idea. Pick up the phone and call them. And let me just have a sip of water. Pardon me. Picking up the phone, better than anything, or like a text. You want to actually make it personal, like do the work, and you'll get a much higher result than just sending an email, okay? So that's going to be one of the best ways as running a win-back campaign. You may even put a deal on it. Like, hey, a real common one is you might say, hey, we're running this new promotion for students, and we're just for ex-students, and we're trying to choose between two promotions and wanted to know which one you like best. You know, it might be like first month half price or $0 registration fee and, you know, get a free guitar or something. You know, you give two different offers and you go, which one do you like best? And you get all your ex-students to reply, and whatever option they pick, A or B, you just offer them that option. They might say, I like B, because you've asked them. Reply with A or B. I like B. Cool. Hey, amazing. Thanks so much for your feedback. Hey, would you like us to set you up with option B before we even take it live? I can do that today for you if you like. So that's an example of a win-back campaign. So, but actually reaching out to your ex-students, putting that on a schedule every, you know, 3-6 months, reaching out to people, a bunch of them will come back, and that's all just takes you a little bit of time and costs you $0. Let's keep moving. I'll give you a fun little Instagram hack that one of our members gave us from the BAM squad, Build a Music School community. Emily shared this idea where she would just go on Instagram to a local school, and her music school would then follow all the parents that follow that school, and then she would end up with all these followers following her back from that school, and it would always turn into several inquiries. And so she would just do this awesome idea and shared it with other people who have then done it and kind of proved it works for them as well. There's a cool little hack. So that's a fun one that you can try. The biggest lesson there really is, though, in the BAM squad, we've got, as I record this video, it's about 430 people running music schools around the world. It's insane. And they're all sharing their best ideas of what's working across not just marketing, but everything. And so if you actually want to be connected to like all the cool little tactics, I'm just giving you like 9 today. That's like a tiniest sliver of what's available. Grab a free trial down below and you can come check it out for free, and hopefully you'll see how amazing it is and stick around. So there's number 4, Emily's little hack. Let's move on to number 5. Ask students or parents to post on social media about you and tag your business page. So social media is amazing, right? But we just want people to reference our business for us. And so how do we do that? Well, one of the ways we did it at our school was things like, let's say we're doing a student concert. Well, hey, take a photo, share it on your social media, tag us, and live here at the show tonight, we'll be pulling winners out and we'll be giving away whatever, this 10 pack of tickets to the movies. That would be a way we kind of bribe people to do it in the middle of a cool event, so they're all sharing. Another thing we did is we got like a big Instagram cutout, so it had like an Instagram board and had our little hashtag or whatever at the bottom, and yeah, our handle, and people would take photos in the frame and they would tag us and go in the draw to win a prize each month. That's another way. But the final way, of course, and is still the best way, is to literally just talk to someone face to face and go, hey, do you mind like doing a cool post about our school? We've got a handful of spaces available, and you've been such an amazing student, and I imagine because you're so cool, you probably know heaps of cool people, and if you're comfortable sharing a post, then that could mean the world for us. So if you've got 5 minutes, would you mind doing that sometime? Just as some sort of nice, just real genuine heart-to-heart conversation with someone, that is the winner. So talk to people, get to know them, and just ask, okay? Ask for the sale, ask for the promo on their social media. Cool, that's number 5. Let's keep moving, right? We're up to number 6. Posting in school newsletters, okay? Most schools have some sort of newsletter going out to students, and they'll have different policies on what you're allowed to add to that and if there's a fee or if it's even an option. But we would literally go into the schools, talk to them, share a little blurb with them that would go into school newsletters and attract just hundreds of students, and build the relationship with those schools. And so that you could then call them back up and do it again in 6 months. So where are all the students hanging out? At school, okay? And so parents are reading those newsletters, kids are reading them, and so you can get this free little advertisement into the schools. Now, in module 5 of the BAM Squad library, we'll put a free link down below. Grab a free trial, go check this out. I talk all about, like, here's literally the script that you go in and you say, and here's how you do it. Here's the process for making sure that you write a really great blurb. You'll see blurb examples and a bunch of other ideas on how we got into schools. And that was literally the thing that grew us to 2,000 students, kind of having the guts to go connect with all these schools and doing lots of different marketing things with them. And I share all of that in module 5. So it's not the topic of today's video, but that is where I'd turn to really see that fleshed out, so you can just copy it and it works. Number 7, let's move on. You want to make sure that you're gathering and sharing student success stories and testimonials. So I've done a video before sharing the circle of cash, the idea that where you basically get a student, you get them an awesome result, say playing their favorite song, you film a video, and then you leverage that video, and then you get another student. And so that is literally the process. It's so easy. You see it all the time with, say, Build a Music School. If you're on our email list, you'll see maybe every couple weeks an amazing success story, because they're just happening all the time. And so some of them will share those with you. And so you're seeing those amazing stories going, oh man, I want that transformation. And then you sign up and join. You do the same thing in your studio. So you need to be capturing videos, capturing testimonials, sharing them on social media, turning them into ads. Now, this is without a budget, so you're not going to spend money on that if you literally have $0. But a little hint, if you've got a video that goes not viral but does well with $0 ad spend, that is the clue that that could make a good ad. Okay, so real simple insider knowledge for you there. That could be worth spending money as an ad. So you want to be sharing that even to your email newsletter, so gathering all the inquiries, putting them on your kind of email list, sending out your monthly newsletter or your weekly newsletter, sharing those stories, and that again is showing little transformations of students, building trust with your audience. And then you want to just each month change up the offer. So, you know, this month, hey, come in and get 2-for-1 trial lessons. So, you know, pay for 1 week, get 2, and that's your trial. That might be your offer this month. Next month, it might be like first month, half price, you know? So you change up the offer that you're giving to people as you're showing these cool testimonials. Let's move on. Number 8, cross promotions with other kids' activity businesses. So if you know, or you want to go connect with a local karate school, martial arts school, a dance school, a swimming school, anything else that's got your audience of children and parents, you go and do a little cross promotion. Hey, we've got this amazing music school or teaching business. Hey, could I promote my music lessons to your people, and I can promote your swimming lessons to my people? Let's do an email on the, you know, on the same day or the same week, and promote each other's things to our email list or share on our Facebook pages. That is one of the most simple ways to grow. And so as you grow, you'll start simple. It might be like, hey, you only teach piano and someone else only teaches guitar. You might literally promote to each other's lists because they may have brothers and sisters that are interested in those different instruments. So you start small like that. And then as you become, you know, bigger and more successful, you might have your own school. And so you might partner with the other dance school or martial arts studio. And then eventually as you get even bigger, you can develop into bigger promotions. So obviously with our school becoming, you know, really big, we were able to do big promotions with like local, you know, fast food restaurants and, you know, music store chains and all sorts of much bigger things, local councils and all sorts of stuff like this. So you just work your way up, and we are basically borrowing their audience to promote. And so we put the work in ourselves to do, you know, the writing and the photos and the emails and the marketing campaign, but we don't have to spend any money because we kind of help each other out. You scratch my back, I scratch yours. We don't have to pay each other any money. So that's a really great strategy as well. That's number 8. Let me give you one more, because I know it's a longer video today, but hopefully super valuable for you. And just a reminder before we do the final one is that down below, I'll give you a link, free trial to the BAM Squad Library. Come check it out. Hundreds of Build a Music School members from all over the world. building their music schools, sharing their best resources. The library is absolutely insane. The private community group's amazing. I'm doing coaching calls with our BAM Squad team as well, other successful school owners from around the world. It's coaching calls happening most days, so you can tune in and talk to us if you want to be part of that. Check it out. You can just grab a free trial. Number nine, final thing I want to give you is that you want to make sure that you're making a compelling offer and you have regular campaigns. So I hinted to this a little bit earlier in one of the points when we were talking about testimonials. You want to think across the year and remember that you want to be kind of building up your email list and building up your followers on, you know, social media and things like that. But there's no point just having followers and never offering them anything. You actually have to have a little bit of a schedule where you've got to put something in front of them and go, hey, do you want to join? Because this month it's, you know, whatever it is. So say, for instance, as I filmed this a few weeks ago, I had my 40th birthday, you know, feeling pretty old, but that was an excuse to go, hey, it's my 40th birthday, so we're doing a flash sale, 40% off. And so we gave this insane deal, which, no, you're not going to be able to get by hearing this video because it's gone. But just for 3 days only, we gave 40% off the BAM Squad membership. And we haven't had that price for like 3 years. And so a whole bunch of people jumped on that because that was put in front of them. And so later on, there'll be some other deal. And it could be because it's Christmas time, or because it's Easter, or it's March Madness, or it's, you know, Fantastic February. Whatever you want to do, you want to think about across the year, when do I want to do some promotions? You might not have the time to do something every month, or the audience size to do that, because you don't want to burn them out with doing way too many promotions. But you want to start with at least quarterly. So, you know, hey, January, we're going to do some sort of big New Year's promotion. April, maybe it's like Easter time, or maybe there's some sort of school holiday break you celebrate, or whatever it is. You pick something 4 times a year and you do a big promotion. You're going to share it to your email list. You're going to share it to your social media. You're going to put posters up around the school. You're going to get your students giving out flyers to friends with some sort of competition. You're going to make sure the word gets out there. And you may even at that point decide to spend a little money on some ads to promote it. But that is the ninth one that I think you should work on that works really well. Actually, just give people a chance to buy, because people love a bargain. They love an opportunity, and you got to put the offer in front of them. So there we go. There's 9 ideas to get you thinking about how you can get students quickly without a budget, spending $0 for pretty much everything on that list. I look forward to hearing how it goes. If you have any other questions about building a successful music school, feel free to get in touch. We'll put a link down below where people can send a video message, and we do some vlogs where we'll answer those questions. But also check out the BAM Squad membership. Come check out what we're doing over there. Get a free trial down below. See you in the next video.